And it's a wake-up call. It is an alarm to the rest of us that we need to train young people, get them into the media, get them into broadcasting, and do away with that stuff so it'll just be a bad memory.
What is this guy talking about? That's what they've been doing to journalism students. You can't turn on a news channel outside Fox News that isn't promoting Democrat or left-wing policies while attacking and demonizing the opposition to those policies. Journalists that stray off that reservation are often targeted and smeared as, quote, right-wing journalists. Just look at what happened to Andy Ngo. He was attacked by left-wing Antifa thugs and then dismissed as a right-wing non-journalist who was asking for it by blue check marks on Twitter. Surprisingly, CNN's Brian Stelter was one of the only ones to speak out about it, even though he dedicated less than 5 minutes to the story. Or how about Tucker Carlson, who yesterday committed the high crime of criticizing Ilhan Omar and is now being attacked and smeared by so-called journalists who are actually just Democrat Party activists? Or how about Tim Pool, who is a liberal left-leaning journalist who is constantly attacked and smeared as right-wing by these people simply because he doesn't toe the Democrat Party line? And we'll get right back to this story, but let me take just a moment to thank our sponsors at RibTea.com. Why not support a top-shelf, American-made product from a company that actively supports free speech on YouTube? Your skin will definitely thank you. Their signature cool nylon silk will keep you dry and comfortable. Be at your best because you feel great. If you buy now, make sure that you use the promo code DroneTech to get 20% off most of their items. After you buy, send me proof of the purchase and I can feature your website or your YouTube channel on my next video. Thanks for your time. Let's get back to the video. Due to this most recent dust-up with Tucker Carlson, CNN analyst Errol Lewis thinks that new journalism students should be, quote, trained to toe the Democrat Party line so that they can do away with all this media that stands in opposition to their goals.
There are a lot of people, I happen to have been one of them as a kid, who saw all kinds of garbage coming out over the airwaves. You know, people like Tucker Carlson. On talk radio in particular, you heard it for years and years and years, just spewing this kind of garbage.
Really, that's the justification you're going to use to censor all political opposition, because I and a lot of other people think that CNN is pure garbage. You might notice that not a single one of these so-called journalists attempts to refute or discredit anything that Tucker Carlson or Rush Limbaugh have said. I want to just point out that CNN and other media outlets have been involved in many smears of Rush Limbaugh over the years, always using edited audio footage to misrepresent what he said. Nope, instead they just throw out their indignation and their labels, and for their audience, that's more than enough. That's what these people have been trained to do, throw out labels instead of convincing arguments, which they run very short on. I suspect this is the exact sort of training these guys want to give to kids, but again, this has been occurring for a really long time, which is why the media is dominated currently by Democrats and left-wingers. Democrats like NBC's Lester Holt, who is about to receive the Walter Cronkite Journalism Award for, quote, caring and fact-based journalism. That's strange to me because I've always known Lester Holt to be a Democrat Party mouthpiece who gives softball interviews to Democrats and treats Republicans like they're a hostile witness.
But I just want to get the answer here. The birth certificate was produced in 2011. You continued to tell the story and question the president's legitimacy in 2012. The rest is an audit of your taxes. You're perfectly free to release your taxes during an audit. And so the question, does the public's right to know outweigh your personal?
Well, I
do want to follow up. Stop and frisk was ruled unconstitutional in New York because it largely singled out black and Hispanic young men.
No, you're wrong.
He also raised the issue of your emails. Do you want to respond to that?
I do. You know, I made a mistake using a private email.
And then no follow-up. 5 fact-checking questions to Trump, Michael Tomasky, 0 to Hillary.
Holter recently joined the anti-Betsy Ross flag mob, and he has literally provided zero coverage of economic expansion under Trump. There was a recent study done by the Media Research Council that found that during the Holt-hosted Democrat debates, quote, 70 of the 102 distinct questions at the two debates echoed liberal talking points or were framed around the liberal worldview, versus only 13 that challenged liberal Democrat assumptions. So yeah, it's pretty clear that modern journalism is taught from a left-wing worldview that demonizes everything that's not left-wing. This CNN analyst, like most modern American leftists, can't stand that people are allowed to disagree and express their points of view.
And it's a wake-up call. It is an alarm to the rest of us that we need to train young people, get them into the media, get them into broadcasting, and do away with that stuff so it'll just be a bad memory.
I like that.
Right. I think what this guy is saying should be an alarm to Americans. These people want to snuff out all opposition and freedom of thought. They want to indoctrinate young people to see the world as they do and to stigmatize all opposing points of view. We're seeing it on all the major platforms right now. We're seeing it at the schools and in the universities. We're seeing it in the media, and now we have this guy openly admitting what they want to do. Indoctrinate a new generation that they hope will finally end the libertarian, conservative, and even moderate movements. Isn't it funny how these wannabe tyrants haven't learned that oppressing people's ability to express themselves just makes them stronger and more determined? That's all I got for you today, folks. Please hit that like button and smash that notification bell. It might not work, but it's worth a try. When you're done with that, head on over to my Teespring store and check out our new design. If you purchase one, send me a picture and I'll put it in a video. Thanks to all of you, and I'll see you in the next video.